Welcome to Medicine Simplified. Today we are going to discuss a disease of middle ear, that is chronic suppurative otitis media. So what is chronic suppurative otitis media? It is a chronic infection of middle ear, of a part or whole middle ear cleft. It is characterized by ear discharge, and permanent perforation of tympanic membrane. Now I'll ask, what is permanent perforation? Usually what happens, all the perforation of tympanic membrane heals within 6 to 12 weeks. But if it is exceeding 12 weeks, then we'll call it as a permanent perforation. So what is permanent perforation? More than equal to 12 weeks of perforation. Let's talk about the etiology. It is most commonly seen in developing countries, mostly in developing countries, and the reason is due to low socioeconomic group. It is common in children, and during examination, if we do culture and sensitivity, so the most common organisms involved are Pseudomonas aeruginosa then Staph aureus and Proteus species. Then, okay, this was about the etiology and major description. Then, CSOM are of two types. First is tubotympanic. Another one is aticoantral. These are the two types, tubotympanic and aticoantral. So tubotympanic type, let's just do the brief description by differentiating both of them, then we'll further discuss each one of them one by one. So the tubotympanic type is also called as safe type, and aticoantral is also called as unsafe or dangerous type. What else? Tubotympanic involves anterior-inferior part of middle ear, whereas aticoantral involves posterior superior part. The discharge from the tubotympanic type is mucoid, odorless and profuse. It is mucoid, profuse and odorless discharge. Whereas in case of aticoantral, it is scanty, purulent, and foul smelling. In tubotympanic type, granulation is uncommon. In antecoital, granulation is common. Granulation is common. One more thing is seen, which is called as polyp, which we'll discuss what it is further when we'll discuss about the pathological changes. So polyp, just write down, polyp is pale in color in tubotympanic type, pale polyp. Whereas in antecoital type, polyp is red or fleshy. So, one more thing, cholesteatoma is absent in tubotympanic type. In antecoital, cholesteatoma is present. Complication is rare. Complication is rare in tubotympanic type. In antecoital type, complications are common. And the main reason for complications are cholesteatoma, as it invades the surrounding tissues and all. So this was the brief description and the difference between tubotympanic and antecoital type of CSOM. So now let's discuss tubotympanic type first, then we'll go on the antecoital type. So tubotympanic, we have already said that it is a safe type. It involves anterior inferior part of the middle ear cleft. The ear discharge, we have discussed how the ear discharge is, and the cholesteatoma is absent. So now just discuss the pathological changes seen in tubotympanic type. Pathological changes. So the very first we'll see perforation. That is central perforation. Suppose this is tympanic membrane. So the perforation will be central. It can be a small perforation, it can be a subtotal perforation, that is half of the pars tensa will be perforated, or it can be a complete perforation. So central perforation is seen. Then second one we'll see, the middle ear mucosa. The middle ear mucosa, it will be inflamed and red. Then the third, what we will see in tubotympanic type is polyp. So what is polyp here? So it is an outgrowth of middle ear mucosa, smooth outgrowth of middle ear mucosa, which is seen in the external auditory canal. Suppose this is middle ear mucosa over here. So through this perforation, and middle ear mucosa's part will be seen in the external auditory canal like this. Here we have perforation, and through this perforation, this middle ear mucosa will appear in the external auditory canal. This is known as polyp. So polyp in this case is pale in color. Is pale. Then the ossicular chain. Ossicular chain. The change is seen in the ossicular chain. Normally it is mobile and intact. But if it is a prolonged case of tubotympanic, in prolonged case, necrosis can be seen. Necrosis can be seen. So the most common bone to be necrose out of those ossicles, three ossicles, is incus. That too, the long process. Suppose this is the structure of incus. This is the short process, this is the body, this is the long process. And here we have lenticular process. So the most common site of ossicular necrosis, if you will get a question, the most common site of ossicular necrosis in case of CSOM or in case of pivot tympanic type, so the answer will be long process of incus. Then we may see further tubosclerosis, and then we may also see fibrosis and adhesion. These are very rare pathological changes in case of tubo tympanic type. Now let's discuss the clinical features of tubo tympanic type. What we'll see, ear discharge, which we have already discussed, it is profuse, mucoid and odorless. Then we'll see hearing loss. Hearing loss when we'll do examination, further examination in audio or using audiometry, we'll come to a conclusion that it will be a conductive type of hearing loss. Then we'll see perforation, central perforation, and we'll see central perforation, which we have already discussed. It can be a small perforation, subtotal or a complete, and at last the middle ear mucosa will turn edematous and red. So this was the pathological changes and clinical features of tubo tympanic type. Now how we will treat it? Till now we discussed about what is CSOM, that is chronic suppurative otitis media, its etiology, its types in brief, the two types, that is tubo tympanic and anticoagulant. We discussed the pathological changes seen in the tubo tympanic type. We discussed the clinical features. Now we'll talk about the treatment options. First, we will go with medical management. Any kind of otitis, any kind of infection in the ear which is causing ear discharge, will first go, and we need to treat it, will first do oral toilet or ear toilet. By default, oral toilet, just to clean the cavity, to remove the debris and etc. Second, we'll go for antibiotics. We'll give systemic or topical antibiotics. In this case, most commonly used antibiotics are neomycin, gentamicin and nowadays we use polymyxin. Second, if it is not treated using medical management, we'll go for surgical management. If there is a granulation, which is very rare or which is very uncommon in case of tubo tympanic type, or the polyp is in the external auditory canal, if there is a presence of granulation and polyps, first we'll remove them surgically before medical management. So if you have a granulation and or polyps, So we'll remove it before medical management, which will help to provide the antibiotics at the proper place and the oral and we can clean the canal very easily. Further, we'll do myringoplasty. Myringoplasty. What is myringoplasty? It is just a closure of perforation. Closure of perforation using graft. This we will do if the ossicular chain is intact and mobile, which is not disturbed. If the ossicular chain is distracted or destroyed, we'll go for tympanoplasty. What is tympanoplasty? It is nothing but myringoplasty. Along with ossicular reconstruction. We have distorted ossicular chain, so we will reconstruct it. So, tympanoplasty and myringoplasty. So, this was about tubotympanic type. Now, we will discuss about anticoantral type. The pathological changes, we discuss everything about tubotympanic type. Now, we will discuss about anticoantral type. So, what is anticoantral type? We have said it is the dangerous or we can say unsafe type. It involves posterior superior part. Posterior superior part of middle ear cleft, and it is associated with cholesteatoma. Because cholesteatoma is having capacity of destructing the bone, this anticoantral type is called as dangerous or unsafe type, because all the complications seen further in anticoantral type is due to the cholesteatoma. Now we will discuss the pathological changes seen in anticoantral type. So the first most common pathological changes seen in anticoantral type is cholesteatoma. Then second, we'll see ossitis and granulation of tissue. And the third last, what we'll see is ossicular necrosis. And the ossicular bone, which is most commonly necrosed, is incus, and that to the long process of the incus. Now we'll discuss the clinical symptoms. In this type also, as in tubotympanic type, we'll see ear discharge, which we have discussed. We'll see hearing loss. And what is new, which we'll see here, is bleeding. Hearing loss, conductive type. Then we'll see ear discharge. That will be purulent and foul smelling. We'll see bleeding. And it is due to granulation and polyps. Sometimes we may see tinnitus and facial palsy. Now let's discuss the clinical signs. We'll see perforation. In case of tubular tympanic, we had central perforation. In case of aticoantral, we have marginal or attic perforation. So, perforation marginal or atical. Marginal perforation will be seen on the margins of like this anywhere, and this on pars placida we may say atical perforation. What else we can see? We will see retraction pocket. This retraction pocket is a sign of actually cholesteatoma, but we'll see in the pathological changes we see the cholesteatoma, so it is also seen in aticoantral type of CSOM, and the last is cholesteatoma. Retraction pocket of tympanic membrane. Suppose this is the middle ear, here we have tympanic membrane. So this part of tympanic membrane will expand posterior superiorly. So this is known as retraction pocket. Now at last, what we need to discuss is the treatment. The treatment is very simple. We very rarely go for conservative management, directly surgical management in case of aticoantral type of CSOM, that is mastoidectomy along with myringoplasty. Not myringoplasty, we have this ossicular necrosis, so we will go with tympanoplasty, that is ossicular reconstruction along with myringoplasty. Nowadays, instead of mastoidectomy, we use modified radical mastoidectomy. So that was all about aticoantral types. So what is CSOM? It is any chronic infection of the part or whole middle ear cleft. And there are two types, tubular tympanic and aticoantral. The aticoantral in the tubular tympanic is also called as safe, and the perforation is central. In case of aticoantral, the perforation is marginal or atical, and it is associated with cholesteatoma, and which has a property of disrupting the surrounding tissues and bones. So, and that is why aticoantral type is also called as destructive or dangerous type of CSOM. And what else we should remember? The ossicular necrosis, which is most commonly seen in aticoantral type, and that the most common bone to be necrosis incus, and that too the long process of incus. So that was all about CSOM. Thank you for watching my video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel Medi Simplified. Thank you.